Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is the kit reveal for March that I will be using for the series I do with a few YouTubers here on how to love a homemade kit. No, for the love of homemade kit. Whoops. So I will put the picture probably right now on what the requirements are or our recipe is for this month. It's on my phone, so when you can view it, I'll just read through everything and then you'll see how I've selected it. So this is for March. So for the paper, it needs to be a recent or new paper purchase, a tiny print or pattern, ombre paper, a bold pattern, and then a specialty paper like vellum, acetate, foiled, etc. So that's for the paper. So recently I purchased a paper pad with a friend and we split it. And it was called like Rainbow Chic, I think. It was a Recollections paper pad from Michaels. So we split it. So all of these kind of rainbow-esque ones are my recent ones. So they already covers for some of them one that I have here. And then they fit into a certain category. So I do want to try to get them used because they really are gorgeous. So for bold prints and stuff, so I do like this one. If you can see, there's like a glitter. Glitter lines within the rainbow. Then this one is a ombre small text that says you can be a rainbow, shine on. This polka dot on white, but all every other sew one you can see is foiled, so that's cool. This one is an ombre, so orange to pink, and it actually in cursive says yellow, pink, red, and orange. This one's ombre as well. This is an old Summer Lights by Pink Paisley. This is a Paige Evans collection, but I do want to get this one used up. It's been sitting in my stash for a while. Another rainbow one with that glitter in there, so you can see how these are all the same paper collection, and I do want to use them because they're so pretty. Here's my bold print again because I figured somehow putting something of rainbow on this black and white would be good. This one as well is my specialty. Like, look at that foil, y'all. So cute. Like, I don't even want to cut this. Like, I already have a vision of, like, just either using a white thicker collection or cut some sort of title out on just white cardstock and keeping it very minimal so that this is the whole showcase of that layout. This one, too, is also beautiful with the foil. Love, love. And then I also pulled out this glitter cardstock, maybe to do a title with as well for one of these. And then I pulled out a few other ones. This is just a bold print, but one of the ones coming up as far as embellishments as to use our punches. So I pulled out my heart punches in three sizes, and I kind of feel like I'm going to do something with this Paige Evans one from Horizon. This also was a recent purchase because this line is at the Joann's now. So I have that one out. And then I have these two out too. This one's also from Horizon. This one. But I kind of feel like I want to cut this tile out and then maybe also cut these flowers out and have them poke through somehow. So like these would make a layout. So I'm already like planning some layouts so that I am not completely in the dark when it comes to, you know, stash diving right now. So then for embellishments, it says to use a roller stamp chipboard, spring themed items, punches, and wood veneer. So I'm not a big wood veneer person, so I just pulled out my little wood veneer having little organizer to hopefully get a few of these pieces used up. Like I said, I'm not a big wood veneer person, so my collection is not that extensive, but because also why I already knew I never was a big wood veneer is because I don't really care for the color of wood being like a light tanny beige cream color. So I've always used them and had to paint them in some ways or glitter them up or heat emboss them. So they're not really an element I go to a lot. So that's my wood veneer. Here are my punches. Here is my roller date stamp. And then here are my spring. I just took this out of my, this is what I keep like all of my florals in my first desk drawer that pulls out. So I'm just gonna keep this one out and use this for all of my spring themed embellishments. These are just leftovers from ephemera packs that I didn't get to use completely up. And so they kind of just house in here. All different collections and even leftovers from die cutting myself. So I'm going to try to use as much as I can from this basket for my spring embellishments. Then for mixed media, it says either art crayons, gelatos, and a mist. So I'm going to cheat a little bit with my mist because I always have my gold Heidi Swap, which I know is discontinued, but I do have a few of these tiny little ones. But maybe also get back into using my I adore this glitter paint. It's not a mist, but in order to get that splatter slash extra element on the page, I just love this paint. It is chock full of glitter, and I can sprinkle this as my splatter for some layouts because it sits on my desk, and I definitely love this stuff. And then I did bust out, I put them in here already, my gelatos. I have a large collection, but I pulled out these that I felt I could use. Don't get me wrong, I haven't used my gelatos in quite some time, and so you can see this is actually gelato, because I was like, dude, are they already dried out? I have no idea. Like, they still have pigment, so I know when I wet them, they'll be activated a little bit more, but they might be dried out. I don't know. We'll see. So, like, yeah, I'm putting them on my... We'll see if my gelatos hold up. If not, I'll just be tossing these and then just playing with my, my sprays that I do have an extensive collection. But as something new that I haven't, I definitely had these sitting on the bottom drawer, not being used, so it'll be good to pull these out and use some. And then, so for chipboard also, sorry, I had my stickers and my chipboard aside. I pulled out what I had left of the Sunny Days collection by Maggie Holmes. I have a full sheet of the Flourish chipboard and a half-used sheet of, this is Bloom. So the flower elements and such, I felt like I could use. Maybe this as a title on something as well. So those are my chipboards. And then my stickers are a black alpha, which does say, or a script, or cursive, or funny, funky font. I don't have anything pretty much as an alpha, but then I just pulled out these because I figured on all those bold backgrounds, something white or gold could be used well. So this one's called Today. This is an old Amy Tangerine, and then this one is Paige Evans Dream. As well for my kit. So I will leave everyone else's links down below. This is the kit I will be using for the month of March. And we have layouts that go out every Monday if you want to play along and hop along with our stash busting homemade kits for the year. Till next time, everyone. Bye.